Okay,
I'm
so.
Like fiance.
All right.
Okay. My name is Lauren Kuhn. I am 32 years old, and I've been sick since February of 2016.
So just go ahead and give us a brief summary of your story.
Okay. I'm a mom of four, and I'm a stay-at-home mom. I have breast cancer, and basically there was a lump in my breast, and I didn't know what it was, but I didn't go to any doctor because I'm like the most relaxed person. I'm like, oh, it's fine, it's no big deal. And 6 months roll by like so fast. Four kids, like it's like nonstop. They were 5 and under. I didn't really start really noticing anything until my body started breaking down. Like I was getting in the bathtub because that was like the place where I got the most relief. I sat up and I felt like three ribs just break in the bathtub just from sitting up. It was worse than childbirth at that moment. Like the pain was just so bad. And I called the paramedics to come like get me out of the bathtub. They took us to the ER. The ER doctor rolls in, naming off all these places that I have tumors in my spine, every rib cage. All over my rib cage, my hips, my pelvis. Just finding out that news, it was like a super shock, you know. At that point, she was like not really hopeful because, you know, she explained to me it was already stage 4, you know, at that point. And the type of cancer it was, you know, spreading quickly. One day I'm just a stay-at-home mom, and the next day I have cancer all over my body. So we moved here to get help from them. When we moved here, I took a turn for the worse. Like, I've been pretty stable and just keeping the cancer at bay, and actually some tumors were going, like dissolving and going away completely. When we moved here, my liver, the cancer had spread to my liver, and it spread so fast, and it was like within a month, I was so sick, you know. One day, she pulls my husband out of the room that we were in, and she tells him, you basically have 2 days to 2 weeks left to live, and there's nothing we can do. I want you to just go home and spend time with your kids and say your goodbyes. And it was like something in me was just like, no, you know, I'm not gonna accept this. I'm not ready to die. Back then there was this song that had just come out like on the radio. And it said, my name is No, my number is No. Do y'all remember that song? Like, you just say, my name is No. Like, you've gotta let it go. It's, you know, every single day is a new day. And you have to decide when you wake up in the morning, am I gonna let cancer win today? You can live every day in fear and the unknown, or you can just choose to live out of faith every day. Today's a new day. It's a new day to be with my family, to live life at its fullest, you know? Know that, you know, whenever it is time for me to go, because we don't know, all of us don't know what day is our last, right? No one is promised tomorrow. Right now, my son that's 4 years old, we are like every day I like take a nap with him because I just want to hold him, you know, and I just want him to remember that. And that's like our time together. And I still believe that God's gonna heal me, but I just want them to remember so much of me. You know, if I am taken from them early. You know, when you're young, you think nothing bad could possibly happen to me, you know? don't, you live life like you could care less. I want you to live every day thinking, like, what is my purpose on this earth? Like, if I was told I only had a year left to live, or if I was in that situation, like, how would I spend the rest of my days, you know? What impact are you gonna leave, you know, as seniors in high school? Your family is important, even if, you know, they make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. Not everyone has family, you know, and just live every day like it matters, you know?